sua mãe. Daniela, yeah. Actually, what is the meaning of I am? What is the meaning of I consciousness? What is the meaning of ego? Well, there are many concepts within that aspect. And practically speaking, we know ourselves, I am, when we are awake. When we are in deep sleep, there is no feeling of I am. But even though in our sleep, if we have some dream, the feeling of I am is there. So what is common in our waking state and in our dream, where the entity of I am is there? So what is the factor which is the reason for the I am? Is our thought. So in waking state we are having thought, and in the dream state we are having thought. Only in the deep sleep alone we don't have thoughts. The same way in the samadhi state itself there is no thought. So there is no I am in the deep sleep and in deep samadhi state. But in all other state, the thoughts are present, and though the I am is also present. The thought is the only reason for the I am. So it is necessary to have the feeling I am for all our relationship. Unless I fix myself, unless I locate myself as I am, I cannot do any action in the world. For example, if I ask you who you are, unless you fix yourself as I am, you will not answer. So when anybody asks a question to ourselves, unless we fix ourselves as I am, we will not answer, because the question the question is put to ourselves. Somebody is asking to, I don't know whom he is asking this question. We don't know. So we have to fix ourselves as I am, then only we can act. So it is necessary in the actual day-to-day life. And for that, our thought is also necessary. And the fixing ourselves is necessary. But apart from the thought, is there any reality? Is there any permanent thing? Because we know the thought is a transitory one. Moment by moment, new thought alone can come. Moment by moment, new I am is also coming. So, but we think something is permanent. Is there anything apart from thought, is there anything permanent? Actually, each and every thought is the combination of the consciousness and the intellectual picture. So each and every thought gives some picture of something. And this picture is in the consciousness. Some consciousness and some picture through memory joins together as thought. So each and every thought, it is some consciousness part is there, and there is an imaginary part, some memory part is also there. So they both joins together and we have thought. So each and every thought, we have the consciousness and the memory portion. So they jointly, we know it as a thought. For example, we look upon a mirror, and in the mirror our image is reflected. But can we separate our image without the mirror? Can we look at the image alone without the mirror? So we cannot have the image without the mirror. So both are same. Some connection is there. Without the mirror, the image is not possible. So, but at the same time, in the real sense, all images, the original state, it is a mirror itself. But at the same time, we don't think, when we look at the mirror, we don't think I am looking at the mirror. We think I am looking at the image of myself. So even we are having thought, the thought is our consciousness is the mirror, and the image upon the mirror is our the memory portion. So they both joins together as the thought. But many persons say, many masters say, the essence of ourself is the reality, that is the consciousness, that is the absolute reality, that is the Atman, that is the witnessing consciousness. Many masters say like this, and the scriptures also say like this. But is there any meaning, or in what way we have to take their statement, whether absolutely we are real, whether what we are seeing is only the image, all images are just like an imaginary thing, it only a reflection, it is not a real thing. But apart from the imaginary thing, apart from the reflection, some substance is there, that is known as the mirror or consciousness. So what is the real state of our consciousness? Because every master say, the reality of ourself, the true nature of ourself is consciousness. And is meant by that. For example, we know we are having a body. We know our body. The total body is sensitive. We feel the total body is sensitive. But how the sensitivity is there? For example, one day I got fever. The total body is feverish, painful. We feel the body, we feel the entire body, and we say the total body is feverish, total body is painful. We can say, I know the body. And when we take some medicine or we adopt some other method, and thereby we get free from our fever. So the fever has gone, the pain has gone. Now, can we feel our body? We know the body is sensitive, but can we feel the sensitivity of the body? When we are in fever, we feel the body. We feel the total sensitivity of the body through pain and fever. But after the fever is gone, can we feel the sensitivity of our body? We may easily say, yes, I know my body, I feel my body, I feel the sensitivity of the body. But, for example, I have my hand here, and in my hands we have 10 fingers. All the fingers are sensitive. But can we feel all the 10 fingers one by one? Because all 10 fingers are sensitive. We cannot feel the sin, we cannot feel the fingers one by one. So if we touch here, we can feel the touch feeling alone. If you do not touch here, we cannot feel anything of it. So if I want to feel the finger, I have to concentrate upon the finger and we have to vibrate the finger. Then only through some activation, I can feel this finger. So here, some activated feeling alone we can feel. So if we cannot activate anything, we cannot feel. But here, the real source, the real status of our consciousness is in the state of unconsciousness. It is conscious, but the real state is in the form of unconsciousness. So that is the nature of consciousness. But what we feel is only the expression of consciousness. But without the consciousness, we cannot feel anything. For example, I touch fire, at once I feel hot. If I touch ice, we feel cold. So, how we can feel? So, is it the sensitivity belongs to the fire? Is it the sensitivity belong to the ice? Not at all. But we feel only the sensitivity of our hand. We feel the sensitivity in one time it is in the form of hot, the other time it is in the form of cold. So the hot and cold belongs to the sensitivity of our hand. But if anybody asks what is the nature of the sensitivity of the hand, if anybody asks the question, will we answer the sensitivity of the hand is in the form of hot, it is in the form of cold? We will not say like that. So this common. So some common factor, that common factor creates the sensitivity, like cold and hot. But apart from the expression, some sensitivity is there. That sensitivity turns into hot, turns into cold. And the basic structure of the sensation, some form of sensitivity is there. So that sensitivity, at one time it becomes hot, the other time it becomes cold. But what is the state of the sensitivity? The sensitivity in itself, what is the form? Nobody can say. So, but it is there, we can infer. So without the real form of sensitivity, no expression as hot and cold is possible. So some sensitivity is there, and that sensitivity takes the expression as hot and cold. But here, the real sensitivity is known as the Atman, or the witnessing consciousness, or the absolute reality. They mention like this. But here, the problem, but because everybody is having some work in the field of spirituality, only for our problem. If you do not have any problem, we will never come to the world of spiritual. So here, we come here to solve our problem. So here, the real sensitivity or the Atman or the witness, does they have any problem? They won't have any problem. Only when we are in the expression, only we are in the expression level, only we are in the supervisory level, then only we have some problem. So here, what we have to do? So that is why many masters say, so the real does not have any problem, and you are having problem. And if you return to the original source, then you will not have problem. Thus, they have your logic like this. So when they say like that, it looks logical. Because the original source is without any problem, and if you return to the original source, then you will not have any problem. So it looks logical. But how you have to return to the original source? So, all the thing we are doing is only in the superficial level, only in the expression level. So, the expression alone as the problem, and the expression alone has to reach the source. But here, the expression, is it necessary? Whether the expression wants to, whether the expression has the necessity to reach the source, is it necessary? So here, all expression comes and disappears naturally. So whenever the expression wants to reach the source, it has to maintain it. Unless it has maintained it, unless it has maintained it, it cannot reach anything. So here, when we put some responsibility to reach anywhere, reach some state, whether it is, it may be the original state or anything, so when we think like that, we have to maintain ourselves. Unless we maintain ourselves, we cannot go anywhere. So here, actually, each and expression comes and disappears naturally. We need not return to the original source. So the main thing is that what is coming is disappearing naturally. There is no necessity to divert the expression to the original source, the original sensitivity. That is not necessary. But the sayings that we have to return to the original source. So in the yogic process, as a practice, as a way of concentration, as a mark, thereby we have to focus our attention. Thereby we can create some energy field by focusing our attention. But that is yogic process. But actually, it is not the case of understanding. But in the case of understanding, actually there is no necessity for ourselves to reach the original source. Actually speaking, we are not away from the original source. Each and every moment, we are in the original source. We are in the reality. We are in the consciousness. There is no necessity to reach again and again. So the image cannot be there without the mirror. No memory is possible without the consciousness. So all thought contains the consciousness. So the thought, the one portion of itself and trying to reach itself is meaningless. So here, what is the main thing is that the all expression in the form of expression or in the form of thought or anything, it has to come and disappears. So that is the main thing. Here there is no necessity to reach anything. But here the I consciousness, the I am, the ego is justified. We can maintain our structure, we can maintain our state as I am if you are related to the external world. But if you are purely psychological, there is no necessity to maintain even ourselves. So if it comes, let it come. If some ego is there, let it be. There is no fault, there is no problem. Everything is permitted. So here, we need not worry about the formation of I consciousness. I did not try to be free from I consciousness. Or we want to have any feeling, any good feeling, or want to be free from bad feeling. That is not necessary. But in the earlier session, as we said, psychologically, we have no effort. No effort is needed. So when there is something to be achieved, some effort is needed. When there is some effort is necessary, somebody must be there to execute the effort. But here, psychologically speaking, everything is meaningless. The I am is meaningless, effort is meaningless, the achievement is meaningless, the reaching a goal, reaching the source, everything is meaningless. So, the psychological structure must be natural. We should not put any part, we should not uphold anything as I am, with some responsibility to do something. So, here this we call understanding the state of ourselves. So, if you understand, no part is necessary, no role is necessary, no status is necessary, no responsibility is necessary. Actually, what is happening is flowing. So we have necessary, we have no necessity to do anything particularly. There is no status, anything to maintain. So we simply some movement, some happening alone is there. So in the name of psychological world, it must be in the form of happening. There should not be any doing. So here, so our responsibility or anything, we can use our mind, because it is inevitable for ourselves to do something without the help of our mind. We have to use our mind for the external use. Otherwise we cannot act, we cannot do anything in the world. For the external world, you can use your mind. But the mind in itself, it must be natural. So whatever it may be, let it be. There should not be any correction. This must be like that, this must not be like that. I must reach something, I must get something. Everything is waste. So here, so that is why the scriptures say, everything is Brahman, Sarvam Brahman, everything is Atman. So it is also like that. For example, if you, when you, in the analogy of mirror and the image, you may take either the total is mirror or the total is the image. Yeah, both are same. So either you have to take it as the image or you have to take it as the mirror. So in this way, the psychological structure must be taken totally as the Atman, totally as the absolute reality, or totally is a shadow, it is a reflection. Then there is no necessity to correct anything. When everything is one, there is no necessity to change anything, there is no necessity to correct anything. So the psychological world must be dismissed either in the name of everything is absolute reality, or everything is in the form of some expression or in the form of reflection, just like shadow. So the main thing is that we have to dismiss the psychological world without any action, without any correction. So we have to take the whole psychological world as a natural world, as a natural functioning. So the total psychological functioning must be happening. There should not be any doing. So if you understand like this, we need not struggle with ourselves. Though the struggling with ourselves is happening only because we select something. So if we select something, means we are dividing our mind into many parts, many compartments. So here, when we accept our total psychological structure as a whole, without any selection, without any division, so the psychologically we become whole. Psychologically we are whole. And when we accept like this, we give way for the natural flow of our consciousness, natural flow of our functioning of our psychological structure. And it happens like this. And we may clarify in some way or other in what this, in the concept of I am.
That question?
Oh.
Before you had defined thought as a combination of consciousness and intellect. And now I've just heard you say that it's a combination of consciousness and memory. But there's a difference between...
So both are same.
Intellect and memory are the same?
Yeah, yes, in this respect, same. Here, for example, the memory function, so thought and intellect is same. So here, the consciousness plus memory, this is thought. So the thought may be considered as intellect. The thought may be considered as mind. The thought may be considered as ego.
Yeah, okay.
But what it is thought. The ego is thought, the memory is thought, the intellect is thought. But the thought, in essence, It is the combination of the consciousness and memory. Some pictures. So the picture is memory, and the picture, the reflection, the mirror is the consciousness.
Could you say why memory? In particular.
Memory?
Yeah.
All memories. Memory means we have some, for example, you have a thought about a tree. Hmm. The tree, we have some picture. You have the picture about a tree. And when you think about a tree, that means some consciousness is there. And in that consciousness, the picture of a tree comes. So that is the memory takes a role of the picture.
So would memory be, if I am calculating a mathematical problem, is that also using memory?
Yeah.
Yeah.
We have some memory. So in the form of some memory, our calculation maybe, so we have some different kind of picture.
Yeah.
Our calculations are based upon some different kind of pictures. Yeah. We have some picture for one and two. Everything, we have some different kind of picture.
Thank you.
All languages are kind of pictures. Mm-hmm. Our language, all symbols related to the mathematics, everything is have some pictures.
Could you say more what you mean by consciousness? Consciousness, you use the word consciousness.
Oh, yeah.
What do you mean by that?
Consciousness, that means the feeling part, some emotional part. So we feel we are having thought.
Yeah.
We feel we have the feeling of thought. We are not unconscious of our thought. We are conscious of our thought. So we feel thought. So that means some sensation is there.
Mm-hmm.
Some feeling part is there. So that is, we are conscious. That is consciousness.
So there's a term, pure consciousness. And when they talk about this term, pure consciousness,
still.
Pure consciousness,
we cannot aware of that. But it is the expression of the consciousness. Even though we can have some consciousness, it is a product of the real consciousness. So here, for example, our scriptures deals with the consciousness into three stages. The one is the waking consciousness. The other one is the dreaming consciousness. The other one is the sleeping consciousness. They consider the sleeping consciousness is also consciousness, but it is pure. But it is consciousness. But the sleeping consciousness is in the form of bliss. But in the bliss consciousness is also a expression of the real consciousness. But right. Even the bliss consciousness is not real. The real consciousness is beyond bliss consciousness. But our sleep consciousness is bliss consciousness. And that is the basic structure of our consciousness. Actually, the original state of our consciousness is in the sleep. In the sleep alone, you are having the original state. So what original state means? Not the real state. The real state is beyond everything. Though we cannot feel, we cannot say or feel anything about that. So we can infer only. But all the expression in the form of sleep or in the form of waking or in the form of dream, everything is the expression of the real consciousness. But all these are the expression. For example, we can direct our consciousness. We can see there or we can hear something. So thereby we are directing our consciousness to receive something. We can change our consciousness from one point to the other point. I can listen something. At the same time, we can look at something. So here, we can change. We can change the direction of our consciousness. So this consciousness is in our hand. And this is not the real consciousness. It is also a kind of expression of the real consciousness. The real consciousness, we cannot know about it.
So consciousness, the way you're talking about it, always has an object in a sense.
No, in the sense it is an object.
It is an object, but always seems to have an object too.
Yeah.
If we can direct our consciousness towards that, then there's something that we're seeing.
Yeah.
and the consciousness in that object seem to be
around so together. Only because of the relationship with the object, we can feel so we have some consciousness and the object. Mm-hmm. So that is that.
Is there any possibilities there, sir, to sense that yet consciousness? How do we know that?
So here, we are having the real consciousness, that the basic structure that we can infer, we cannot feel. But at the same time, we can divert our consciousness. For example, when I see you, I focus my consciousness upon you. And at the same time, if somebody goes there, I change my consciousness from you to that person. So here, I operate my consciousness. This consciousness within my operation. I handle my consciousness. This is the expression of the real consciousness. The real consciousness is the base that we cannot feel.
You were saying something about, you were mentioning the notion effortless, which I really love, and I feel that as a Western boy, I sometimes have, like I need to use some effort to be in the state of being. I mean, effortless. And you were also saying something about responsibility. And then after you were saying that we should just accept ourselves as we are. And there's something that I don't quite understand, because I feel that this sort of responsibility, I wonder if this responsibility is towards ourselves or towards God. Like,